Action News Now Storm Tracker Weather. Coverage you can count on.
We're practicing social distancing, so Court Klopping is in the Weather Center right now, joining us with the latest on conditions.
Yeah, that's right, Linda. And what we're seeing as we head towards your weekend forecast, temperatures are warming up. We're going to be seeing some 70s out there in the valley for your first weekend of the spring season. Some scattered mountain showers are still possible. That's mainly tomorrow afternoon and evening, and it's very limited as far as the time frame for when we could be seeing showers on the way. We're going to show you that in a second. And then we will see a more widespread area of wet weather moving through early to midweek next week as two different areas of low pressure converge and result in rain and snow on the way, as well as a big cool down. Temperatures outside this evening, we're still in the low to mid 60s, a comfortable evening in the valley. Higher elevations, mostly seeing 40s to 50s right now, and we're in the low to mid 50s in the foothills. Meanwhile, winds mostly out of the north at the moment. You can see them out of the northeast for Redding, northwest for Red Bluff, and out of the north to 6 miles an hour right now in Chico as well as Paradise. Winds are mostly going to be less than 10 miles an hour out of the north tonight. And then you take a look at satellite and radar. We are tracking some active weather down to our south and east. Chance for thunderstorms along I-80. Otherwise, we're seeing mostly dry weather for Northern California this evening because of that high pressure we have just overhead to our north. Meanwhile, low pressure retrograding back out to the west. That's what's going to give us that chance for some scattered showers moving in tomorrow. And then you can see low pressure off the coast of Southern California. That's going to track towards the west coast through your weekend. When tomorrow we're actually going to see those showers possible from that system off to our east, that then moves off to the east, and then it's the system to our south that brings the chance for showers Sunday night. That's going to converge with this next low pressure area dropping down from the north. That ramps up those showers Monday through Wednesday of your extended forecast. Snow levels dropping to 3,000 feet by Monday night, staying in that same range on Tuesday, and then down to 2,000 feet on Wednesday. So rain and snow is in your forecast next week, and temperatures are really cooling down as well. Temperatures tomorrow, mid 50s to low 60s in the northern mountains. We'll see mostly sunny skies and then the chance for some showers in your afternoon. Same conditions for the Sierra and Cascades, just not quite as warm. Mostly in the 50s for tomorrow after dropping into the teens to 20s overnight. 30s to 40s in the foothills overnight. Mid 50s to low 60s tomorrow afternoon. And if you're in the valley, it's high 30s for the northern zones. High 60s to low 70s tomorrow afternoon with sunny skies. Mid-valley areas in those high 30s to low 40s for the start of your Saturday, ending up in the mid to high 60s with sunshine for your afternoon. Your Storm Tracker 7-day forecast, where your weekend's always in view. High 60s to low 70s, sunny to mostly sunny for the valley through your weekend. A drop back into the low to mid 60s on Monday with showers. Expecting to see snow totals up to around a foot above 6,000 feet. Rain totals for the valley Monday through Wednesday looking to be a half an inch to an inch, so some shower activity moving through, and then another round of wet weather looking likely after a little break on Thursday. That'll arrive Friday heading into next weekend. Linda.
All right. Thank